Thank you for coming to tonight's performance of the Suzanne Farrel Ballet, the Kennedy Center's own ballet company. Please welcome our ballet mistress, Kristen Gallagher.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Kennedy Center's Millennium Stage. Tonight, we are pleased to bring you an evening of ballets by George Balanchine with a sneak peek of the upcoming season at the Kennedy Center Opera House, opening in just 2 weeks. We'll show you excerpts from our season, as well as a few wonderful ballets that are unique to our company. We will start tonight's performance with Walpurgis Nacht Ballet that George Balanchine choreographed for Suzanne Farrel, to be performed only once at a special gala performance. But the ballet turned out to be so popular that it became part of the regular repertoire. As part of our season's nod to the 400th anniversary of William Shakespeare's passing, we'll see Balanchine's exquisite and serene pas de deux from the second act of A Midsummer Night's Dream. Meditation will follow. This is a work that is particularly special for Miss Farrel. It is one of the first ballets that Mr. Balanchine made for her, and it started many years of close collaboration between them. In between, you'll enjoy a few video snapshots from our dancers so that you can get to know them a little better. Let's begin tonight's performance.
I've always wanted to be a dancer ever since I was a little girl. It's a cliche, but it's true for me. I met Suzanne at the audition for the company, and I remember feeling like I am now at loss for words. I didn't know what to say. With very few words, sometimes she can explain. And what she asks of you to do in the movement, when you do the movement that way, that also communicates to you certain things about the meaning and about how the moment should feel. There's a lot of common myths. People tend to just focus on the glamorous part, whereas the glamorous part is a much, much, much smaller percent of the whole thing, which consists of a lot of work on yourself, constantly improving. Dancers are much more multifaceted than the public seems to think. We're not just tutus and tiaras. Some days, when you've done well and you feel everything is right, and you feel just so content and satisfied and gliding, you're gliding when you walk home. And then some days when it hasn't been a good day and you're frustrated with yourself, you just can't wait for the next day to make it right.
Thank you. started dance when I was 5 years old in tap and acrobatics, and then did jazz. And it wasn't until I was 12 when one of my dance teachers said, you should try ballet class. And so I did. And the first thing I did was an audition for the School of American Ballet. I had no idea what I was doing, and I got accepted. And something about the movement quality and the way that it made me feel as a dancer just opened my eyes to a whole new world of how to move, and I just fell in love. I started working for Suzanne in 2007 with the Partnership for Cincinnati Ballet, and I went in completely blind. I had no idea what to expect, and I met Suzanne the night before we started working, and it was on the elevator at the hotel, and she walked on, and of course I knew who she was as soon as she walked in, and I was starstruck and said, hi Suzanne, I'm Michael, I'll be working for you. And she just looked at me and put her head back down. So I was very nervous to start the next day, never taking her class before, and everyone told me to be careful. Her classes are so difficult and challenging, and they make you think all the time. Suzanne always has a way of pulling something out of you, and if you give her everything you have, she gives it all back to you and shapes it, and by the time you're on stage, it just feels so good. It feels right. I've always wanted to be a dancer. I don't necessarily like speaking in public. I'm a very shy, private person when it comes to my life. But on stage, you can be whoever you want to be when you're performing. And, you know, there's a separation, but the audience still feels that they're a part of you when you perform. And that's a really wonderful feeling.
Thank you.
This year, we celebrate the 50th anniversary of Balanchine's Don Quixote. It's a unique ballet in the Balanchine repertoire. It is one of the few full-length ballets that Mr. Balanchine ever created. And it is a completely original dance work based on Cervantes' famous epic, not on the popular 19th century Russian ballet versions. Don Quixote is historic because not only did Mr. Balanchine create the central ballerina role for Miss Farrel, it is the only ballet in which they dance together on stage, Balanchine as the Don himself, and Miss Farrel as his ideal vision of Dulcinea. The ballet is also unique to our company, as we are the only company that has recreated and performed the complete production. Our production premiered here at the Kennedy Center in 2005 and toured to the Edinburgh Festival and was also performed by the National Ballet of Canada as an artistic partnership with our company under Miss Farrell's guidance. To celebrate this anniversary, we will perform two pieces from the second act divertissements. For the Ritournelle, our company's former principal dancer, Bonnie Pickard Schofield, will return to the stage with a very special appearance by her young daughter, Penelope. The music for the Ritournelle has never been recorded, so we are delighted to have pianist Amanda Halsted here to accompany us this evening. The second divertissement is the powerful and exciting Pas de Moresque. Following these excerpts, we will show you a few more sides of Mr. Balanchine. There will be an excerpt from the ballet Episodes, one of Balanchine's famed black and white ballets. Here, Anton Webern's music is paired with the stripped-down essence of ballet, revealing both the music and dancing in vibrant form. Then we'll return to our season sneak peek with a breathtaking quiet pas de deux from Emeralds, which we hope you will return to see in full during our Opera House season. Thank you.
It wasn't something that I was conscious about it. Almost like dance found me and rescued me. I felt in love with it. So it was almost like a dream for me. Still is. I started dancing in Argentina, where I'm from, and I come from a very poor family. My country is beautiful, but the economy always goes up and down, sadly. So my family was struggling a little bit. I mean, my father worked really hard, but it wasn't enough. So my mother started looking for free tuition for me, and I got into the school, the Institute of the Theater Colón in Buenos Aires. I was lucky to start working when I was very young. So I went through the ranks very early. To be a dancer in the Suzanne Farrel Ballet is, I think it's almost like a privilege. It's one of the most beautiful things that can happen to a dancer. The way she encourages you and she makes you a better person, a better artist. I think it's a gift. I don't know, from life or from someone that it was given to me, like, so I'm so grateful for that. I truly believe that as an artist, you always need to keep learning. I think the day you think, oh, I'm the ballerina I wanna be, that's the day that actually your career, you as an artist, you start going down. Also in life, I think you constantly keep learning and learning and learning. And to work with Suzanne, to work with someone that is willing to give so much, her dancers would say, like, she always gives us freedom. And what that means, I think, is like, she trusts us, we trust her. To have a person that you trust in front of you and is so positive, I think that is the best you can have. It's a gift that I'm trying to embrace every single day. The music, the lights, the costumes, the sets, the energy of having live orchestra, the energy of the audience in front of you. You cannot see them, but you can feel them sometimes. I think it's magic. And to create magic for someone else, I think it's beautiful. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
Thank you to everyone who has joined us here and online, and we hope that you will join us for our Opera House performances in just a few weeks. Performances are October 30th to November 1st, right here at the Kennedy Center. We will leave you with the pas de deux from Stars and Stripes, Mr. Balanchine's way of honoring America through dance. Thank you.